I play Jake, and he's a sort of successful lawyer. He's got a new wife or fiance, and he's on his way to a business meeting, and he has a car crash, which renders him unconscious, and he wakes up in this strange house in the middle of nowhere with this beautiful young girl, played by Diana Vickers, sort of flirting with him, and he's literally no idea what's going on. Her father returns home, played by the wonderful Tony Curran, and every sort of attempt that he has to leave this house and get back to his normal life seems sort of thwarted by circumstance, and he can't leave. And then it sort of escalates into a rather vicious finale, shall we say. It was a joy. The three of us got on so well, and the film is quite dark, so we needed to lighten the mood, in between takes. So it was wonderful, and I met two really, hopefully, lifelong friends with the two of them. So yeah, that was amazing. In fact, that's what attracted me to the film in the first place, was that it was heavily character-led and just the three of us really talking for a lot of it, which was, attractive for an actor, I think. This is my first time at Fright Fest, my first time at a premiere ever, and it's extremely exciting. And I think the horror genre is particularly important now because there's a sort of new wave of filmmakers coming through this sort of digital age where, film is not as expensive as it used to be, and the horror tends to be where people start off. And I know Mark's made a film before this one, but he's still a young director. These are early days for him, and I think horror gives that opportunity to get your foot in the door of the film industry. So things like Fright Fest celebrate that, and I think that's great. I'm actually rehearsing in the full Monty, the stage version, at the minute. So it's nice to have my clothes on for a change. Well, I've not seen it yet, but this is a great psychological thriller / horror. If you like blood, you'll get that. If you like drama, you'll get that too. So I hope you enjoy it.